University at the Raven's Nest in Ottawa, Ontario, to take in this game between the Lakehead Thunderwolves and the Carleton Ravens. At 6-1, and we are already underway as a foul is called here.
Well, certainly,
so Hawkins, wearing number 14, or 15, I should say, will inbound the ball to Ali Bush, who last night led the Ravens with 7. And that one is drained off of the rebound, I believe. Out of bounds, and it's going to remain Thunderwolves' ball.
You know, I've really been impressed with Kendall McLeod's development over her time here at Carleton. Maybe even I'll do a little more scoring.
Gordon inside to Lindsay Drury, and she opens the scoring for the Thunderwolves. 5-2 now for the Ravens. Play. In fact, no fouls called thus far, and we're over 3 minutes into the game.
Absolutely, and it has been a great game, actually. It's been fairly well played by both.
gets the layup to go. 7-2 now for the Ravens. So Coach Charles evidently
the mismatch, and Ashley Cleary had a difficult time covering from the perimeter the point guard. And then expect to complete a pass. You have to square down and through and be as tough or tougher than they're playing you.
So it was, in fact, Cal. And it's going to be McNulty picking up the foul.
Well, the baseline official had a jump ball called, but...
Mark rebounded by McLeod. Van Slingerland also had her hands on it, and Kendall McLeod gets the layup to go off the high shot.
Well,
Slingerland drained from three-point territory, and the Ravens take a 10-point lead. It is 12-2 with 4:24. Marauders.
Well, I would say that it's night and day for all the Ravens. They just look like they're playing with so much focus and with a... Feed the ball through the post, but not with a post standing outside of the post position. He wants his post player back in the low post area. Of possession, she caught the ball well outside of her comfort zone and position, but decided to attempt to attack off the dribble against the quicker Cleary. And then
in the final minute of the opening quarter. There's Bruni. Bruni drives, blocked. Here in the first quarter.
They really do, and led by Kendall McLeod, in my opinion. She is so focused at both ends of the floor. She always plays hard. She always plays. Focus, because the truth is, if they keep the chip on their shoulder and this level of focus, we could see a route over a very good Lakehead.
In fact, it was exactly 1 year ago today that the Ravens went into Lakehead in Thunder Bay. In that game were led by 16 points by Kendall McLeod. So Bill, apparently Kendall likes playing against this Thunderwolves team throughout her career thus far.
Started to go without Lindsay Drury, the starting post, the starting center, and a very solid rebounder in this league.
Very strong second unit developing for this Ravens squad as players like Resch and Hawkins continue to as Lakehead knocked that ball out of bounds. I believe that was Ashley Randall who last touched it, and the Ravens will inbound. Home team. There's a pass across by Nikuliak on the floor for the first time.
Told if you're not going to pull the trigger right away, go ahead and attack. There aren't many people who can keep Ali Bush in front of them, so in that way. He's in good standing to keep up the defensive intensity, and they certainly have played defense in the quarter court extremely well tonight.
Bounded now to McNulty. Shot taken there by Ross. The double-digit point plateau. Jessica Rush takes the long-range shot off the mark, rebounded by Melody. She gets it to go awkwardly.
In talking with her coach during her last time off, she is frustrated, and for good reason, by this Ravens defense.
But there she- Just under 7 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Ali Bush for three, and she gets it to go, answering right back. Jessica Resch battles to keep that ball in her hands. Ali Bush was unguarded, though, and she got the pass easily. Elizabeth Roach.
Defenders up to her and laying down the bounce pass. Unfortunately, missed the layup, but the other post was there for the offensive rebound, and we have a foul situation. Text.
after 73% from the free throw line, misses the first one here. Already on this young season, averaging 7.
Hawken.
So there's McKenna, the Timberly Nova. The foul here. She shows her frustration on that one.
Well, it's a difficult call to make with the shot clock going down.
Kendall McLeod takes the pass from Bailey Lomas. Across to Van Slingerlin. She takes the three. It's off the mark. Rebounded by
allowed her to dribble right, which is a cardinal sin in Coach Charles' defensive philosophy, and she took the foul knowing that.
For the Thunderwolves, and Allie Bush just adds to their misery.
Well, that was a great recognition by Allie Bush. She knew the matchup she had drawn on this time.
Bush into the hands of Drury, back outside to Calcan, whose three-point shot was way off the mark.
Down and use that frustration to your advantage. Gain a tough rebound. Dive for a loose ball. Inspire your teammates with your anger.
Caught hands. They're spreading the ball out and giving it to anybody who wants it.
Well, they really are. And in fact, when you were mentioning spreading the ball out, they're also attacking.
Can't, of course, see what he's thinking inside his mind. But Allie Bush with the ball now for the Ravens.
Coming with the 1-2-1-1 full court zone pressure. They trapped early, and Carleton had quite good success with it earlier, but not.
Pass across by Zink over to, or rather, Zink takes the pass back. Ross. Into the hands of Bailey Lomas, and now Resch will take it back for the Ravens. Jessica Resch trying to find room, pass. Great defensive pressure by the Thunderwolves off of that timeout. And McKenna now drains the basket.
Initial outlet pass has to be foul line extended area so that it's higher up the court. And Coach Charles will, on a technical.
So Van Slingerland will. 17 points, and a three-pointer drained off of the glass by Sarah Gordon. And so Lakehead just...
coaches asked, but how hungry you are during those cuts and how aggressive you are to the ball, catching the ball, squaring.
Highlighted off of that last timeout that John Kreiner called about 10 minutes ago.
They've dropped back into the quarter court, and Lakehead has played more aggressively in the quarter court as well. So Lakehead has to... by taking the press that was working off and trying to change up the D. Why not find out if it's still going to continue to work even after the other team's timeout?
McNulty completes the three-point play. McLeod inside to Roach. Elizabeth Roach with 3 seconds left in the second quarter. She defense.
Well, I hope that's the case, because as a coaching staff, they have to be disappointed with the defense on that possession. It's as if they were walking into the locker room long before the buzzer.
Halftime leading 43-28. We'll have the halftime stats and more after this. welcome back to the Ravens' Nest at Carleton University. Second half action already underway. The Ravens went into halftime with a 43-28 lead. Welcome to all those who are just joining us. This is Asher Roth along with Bill Arden. Ravens shot 60% in the first half, led on the heels of 10 points by Christovan Slingerland on 4-for-5 shooting, including 2-for-2 for three-point territory. Sarah Gordon led the Thunderwolves with 7 as Emily Ross opens the scoring here in the second half. Thunderwolves now have 30 points. They trail by 13.
And right off that score, they come back again with their full court zone pressure. And yet again, Carleton struggling, playing against it.
Ravens had seven different players light up the score sheet, most of which repeat offenders, you might say. Thunderwolves have control of the ball now. There's Tasha McKenna. McKenna over to Ross. Ross back to McKenna. Ross gets called for traveling. So Ravens will get the ball back.
It will be interesting to see if Lakehead attempts to work the matchup of Drury versus Darcy. She's in foul trouble with 3 fouls and wouldn't like to get the 4th early.
Bailey Lomas over to Cleary. Cleary takes the long shot, misses, rebounded by Zink, who will take it back for the Thunderwolves. Darcy Zink inside to Kalkan, her shot off the mark. It's going to be Thunderwolves' ball as the Ravens knocked it out of bounds.
On any given night, Coach Charles would be delighted with a 15-point lead at half, but not when it came as a result or after having had a 23-point lead. Certainly the momentum shifted with the pressure that applied by the Lakehead Thunderwolves in the final 5 minutes of that first half. Let's hope that Carleton can regroup and go out with the intensity that they started the game with.
Thunderwolves outscored the Ravens 22-20 in the second quarter after being outscored 23-6 in the first. Malati picks up foul number 4.
It's interesting. I was mentioning Darcy Hawkins. She was in foul trouble at the halftime with 3, and she started the half. Coach Charles didn't like what he saw. He pulled her off for Malati. Malati quickly picks up her 4th. So now we'll see through without picking up her 4th for a little while anyway.
There's some frustration shown, and looks like Emily Ross can't believe that she got called for the foul there.
Certainly Lakehead is challenging Carleton in every way, and they are challenging them physically right now, and we'll see if Carleton is going to respond.
So Ross picks up her 3rd personal foul. Ravens just trying to leave their own midcourt. And Slingerland across to Bush. Bush got challenged there by Ross. Passed over to Jessica Resch. And a foul is going to be called off the play, I believe, by Ross once again. So she picks up number 4.
No, I believe referee noticed that the shot clock had not been reset for Carlton's new possession. He then had to select that they have 15 seconds left, and that's where we'll start with this inbound.
So regardless, Ross did not pick up foul number 4, but she gets subbed out by Coach Kreiner. Resch now over to Bush. She finds Van Slingerland with 5 on the shot clock. An air ball rebounded by Cleary, and she gets the layup off the glass. And her strong positioning continues just as it was last night against McMaster. There's McKenna over to Gordon. Gordon has her pocket picked by Van Slingerland, who then knocked it out of bounds. It's going to be Thunderwolves' ball with 10 seconds left on the shot clock and 7:48 left to go in the third quarter.
Bit unfortunate for the Ravens there. Great positional defense leading to what I thought might have been a turnover. However, Lakehead ball.
Ball inbounded by McKenna over to McNulty. Outside to Zink. Zink driving against 2 Ravens defenders. And it looks like she drew the foul on that play against the Ravens.
A bit unfortunate, too, that the original travel call on, don't have the player's name in front of me, sorry, McNulty wasn't called, and the play was allowed to continue. Again, decent defense by the Ravens, just a step late.
So Zink goes 2 for 2 from the line, 45-32 now the Ravens lead. And Slingerland with the long pass across to Resch, who now drives. Resch outside to Ali Bush. Bush, with the defense draped all over her, finds Resch. Resch tried to drive, bounced the ball off of a shoe into the hands of Lindsay Drury. And so AZ Kalkan picks up foul number 3 for the Thunderwolves.
Kendall McLeod in for Ashley Cleary. We'll see if Kendall can rediscover that beautiful touch that she showed early on in this game.
Jessica Resch's layup attempt off the mark, and then she hit the ground trying to fight for that ball, and she got into a very physical battle there with AZ Kalkan. Perhaps showing some frustration for her struggling shooting. Resch comes into this game shooting only 24% on the season, but McLeod gets that jumper to go.
A jumper that I think was actually a pretty timely and pretty important to settle the troops down, and hopefully this half will start to go the Ravens' way.
McNulty takes the long shot with Bush all over her and drains it easily. ...47-34, Ravens by 13. There's Jessica Resch, passed over to Hawkins. She gets the easy basket uncontested from inside the paint.
Well, better attack from the second row guards against the pressure there led to the wide-open jumper, and Darcy Hawkins knocked it down.
McKenna has her pocket picked by Hawkins, who now drives towards the net uncontested. Hawkins puts up the layup and gets it to go. An OUA dunk, you might call that layup. 51-34 for the Ravens. And Thunderwolves draw the foul on that play and will go to the line. The foul is going to be called against Jessica Resch.
Coach Charles, first defensive principle to not allow an attacking penetration with a strong hand, was given up there. And Coach Charles not happy with his team's defensive effort on that possession.
So Resch picks up her first foul. Zink goes to the line once again. Comes into the game shooting under 50% from the line. 51-36, Ravens by 15. McLeod inbounds it to Van Slingerland. Over to Bush. Ali Bush back to Van Slingerland, inside to Kendall McLeod. Out to Hawkins, she takes the 3 off the mark, rebounded by Resch. Her pass to McLeod knocked out of bounds. It's going to be Thunderwolves' ball. Looked like some miscommunication there from in close.
Yeah, I think that Kendall McLeod was expecting Resch to throw the putback up after the rebound, which is a fairly common thing to expect, so I don't blame her for that turnover.
McNulty with Hawkins on her. McNulty driving, her shot blocked, knocked out of bounds, it looked like, by Chelsea Nikuliak. Looked as though she spiked it out of bounds in an attempt to knock it off of a Ravens player.
Well, Lakehead certainly playing a little bit aggressive, and Carleton not being goaded into anything undisciplined so far.
McLeod to Resch inside, pulls up, her shot way short. And she continues to struggle mightily with her shot. Two players go to her aid and pat her on the back there.
But she certainly doesn't look as though she's playing confidently, and of course a slump can certainly do that to you. She's got to turn it around, and the best way to do it is to focus on defense. You know, if you focus on defense and not at all on offense, it can help loosen you up on that end of the court, and maybe the release will get a little bit better and a little bit less hesitation in it.
Hawkins misses the second free throw after draining the first. Ravens lead by 16. 5.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Long shot by McNulty, way short, rebounded by Resch. Elizabeth Roach runs right through Katie Ulakovich. Resch back to Hawkins, and a foul is going to be called here against Nikuliak.
And I'm certain that that's not a foul that Lakehead coaching staff is happy about. She was attacking somewhat, however, her angle was going to be driven out of bounds on the baseline without really threatening the rim at all. Tough to let her off the hook.
So Nikuliak with her first foul of the game. Long pass over to Resch, whose shot is short. Tipped out of bounds by McKenna, but it is going to be Lakehead ball as the Ravens must have been the last ones to touch it. So Emily Ross, or rather Tasha McKenna, will lead the attack for the Thunderwolves. McKenna over to Ulakovic. She takes the three, and it's nothing but net. From downtown Thunder Bay, 52-39, Ravens by 13. Thunderwolves have made a game of it after a very slow start. Roach to Resch. Resch being awarded minutes by Coach Charles, just trying to get her out of that slump. She draws the foul on this play and puts the Thunderwolves into penalty territory with 4:33 left to go in the third.
That was certainly a decent attack by Resch. It'd be nice to see her knock the shots down from the foul line here. With that said, she did miss an assignment on the defensive end of the court, and as you mentioned, Coach Charles electing to build her confidence with some play time. We'll see if she's going to be subbed out for that defensive miscue as we see subs ready to check in, depending on the success of this foul shot.
And so Resch goes 2-for-2 from the line, and she will sub out, awarded for her strong defensive play towards the end of her shift there. Still looking somewhat dejected on the bench, though. 54-39, Ravens by 15. There's Bruni across to Ulakovic. Now back to Gordon. Gordon had her pocket picked, but I believe Ben Slingerland is going to get the foul here as her defense was just a little too aggressive.
Certainly a good call by the official there. However, I do like the fact that Van Slingerland came over and committed fully to the help situation. Needs to get her hand a bit out of the play. But with that said, I'm pleased with that rotation on defense.
Bruni's inbound pass missed by Ulakovic. Or the shot, I should say, was missed by Ulakovic. Van Slingerland now driving. Nice pass inside to McLeod. Her layup off the mark as she was pressured there before that shot. Rebound pulled down by Sarah Gordon. Taken the other way by Karina Bruni. Cross now to Izzy Kalkan, inside to Drury. And the question now is, does Van Slingerland pick up the foul here, or is that a jump ball?
I believe they've signaled jump, and you know, that was a great double down by Van Slingerland too. Leaving Drury alone with Darcy Hawkins with three fouls would have been ill-advised. It was great Ravens defense to collapse on the post entry.
So Kalkan over to Bruni, back to Kalkan for three, just short, couldn't get the bounce to go in. And Hawkins pulls down the rebound across to Lomas, now to Roach.
Coach Kreiner lamenting the fact that his troops did not seem interested in going for an offensive rebound on that last shot attempt, leaving Drury alone, and that's not going to get it done. You need more people to the offensive glass than that if you want to come back from 15-point deficit.
So Kalkan went on the attack there, trying to draw the interception, but knocked it out of bounds herself. Lomas with the inbound pass to Ali Bush, back out after a lengthy rest. And the three-pointer nailed by Kendall McLeod. She continues to have the hot hands, and her three-point shot has improved dramatically over the past few weeks. 57-39, Ravens back up by 18. And a foul is going to be called off the play. And it's going to go against Katie Ulakovic, sending the Ravens, I believe.
She was a little aggressive setting a screen inside the key. Referee felt she extended her arm.
So despite the fact that that was off the play, it was still considered an offensive foul, so the Ravens don't get the free throws.
again, the Ravens need to do a better job catching the outlet in a better attack position and not such an easy one to trap.
Inbound pass to Ali Bush. She speeds her way back down the floor. The defender's a little slow on the uptake. Darcy Hawkins took the pass. Missed, but Kendall McLeod right underneath the basket for the rebound gets the uncontested layup.
Great shift.